Far Cry Primal's new Survivor mode isn't just a way to make the game tougher. It's a way of fundamentally changing the experience and the way you play, especially if you've turned on one of the permadeath options. If you're wondering whether to embrace the full caveman experience, here's how Survivor mode and permadeath changed Far Cry Primal for us. Survivor mode's most obvious change is that it turns off the minimap, which pushed us to pay more attention to our surroundings. By that, I don't just mean that we had to study the landscape to get our bearings. We can, after all, still use the bigger map and set on-screen waypoints. I mean that losing the minimap strips away an early warning system that shows you when enemies and predators are nearby. Keeping a sharp eye and an open ear is now key to avoiding or surprising threats, and stealth and scouting are more important than ever. If you're in the habit of charging at Udom hunting bands with a club or spear, you may find yourself overwhelmed by enemies you didn't know were there. On the other hand, Survivor Mode's world is less populated during the day, so while you'll want to stay vigilant about wandering into an ambush or startling prey, it's not something you'll have to worry about as often. You may even find you can take a bonfire or two without a fight, so don't be afraid to explore and really get to know your surroundings. You'll also want to avoid exerting yourself unnecessarily. Every action now drains your stamina, and as your meter hits bottom, Takar becomes slower and weaker, and he'll start grunting and moaning until you can find a safe place to sleep. This isn't just an inconvenience, though. The need to sleep gives Far Cry Primal a more concrete sense of time passing, and makes the land of Urus feel just a little more real. Fitting in a mission or capturing an outpost during a busy day of hunting and foraging now feels a little more meaningful, as each well-earned rest brings you a little closer to total control of Urus. Having to sleep doesn't mean you'll miss out on nighttime. Just sleep until nightfall and head out with full stamina. Anything less is risky, because fast traveling to safety won't always be an option. Fast travel now eats up food and stamina depending on how far you're going, so if you don't leave yourself enough meat or energy for the trip, you may be stuck in dangerous territory until sunup. Even during the daytime, you'll want to keep a close eye on your resources. Missing with a ranged attack now frequently means your arrow, spear, or club will shatter on the ground, and crafting new ones takes a few seconds of holding down a button and waiting for a meter to fill, during which the action doesn't pause. And with crafting materials more sparse in Survivor mode, you'll want to be extra sure of your shots, whether you're aiming at a deer's flank or an enemy's head. Turning on permadeath means you risk all the progress you've made whenever you're in danger, so you'll want to be extra careful with your single, fragile life. If the odds are against you, there's no shame in running or hiding. Buying the Sprint Heal skill early on made this tactic a little more effective for us, as it let us patch ourselves up while we fled like Stone Age cowards. We quickly learned to take similar care with the lives of our animal companions, who can't be revived if you let them die. That's not such a big deal in itself, because taming a new companion is still pretty easy, unless you're going for a bear or saber-toothed tiger, who you now have to fight. But losing your four-footed friend in the middle of a confrontation, or worse, when you're out at night, leaves you without anyone to watch your back, help you hunt, or waylay pursuers, making your own death much more likely. And if you've managed to tame one of the legendary beasts, you want to be extra careful. They're tougher than most, but if they die, you won't be able to get a replacement. Now that the simple act of fighting a few Udom carries so much more danger, we also retaught ourselves to use Far Cry's time-honored stealth tactics. Which is to say, we hid in a bush and threw rocks to lure enemies out of the open, one by one, for quick takedowns. It's not as much of a rush as impaling them with spears or cracking their heads with a club, but it keeps Takar alive. And the longer you can do that, the longer you'll be able to experience the unique risks and rewards of Far Cry Primal's Survivor Mode. Survivor Mode is available now as a free patch for Far Cry Primal on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. For more on Far Cry Primal and other Ubisoft games, keep your eye on UbiBlog.